جعفر احمد يونس بيت. نعم okay, since Dr. Ahmed is not here. I'm going to start the recording. If anyone has any thoughts, concerns, or questions, please wait till the end. We will allow questions, and then you can raise your hand and ask your questions. Dr. Mohammed, in your right hand.
Okay, are you sure my slide? My slide is shared now?
No, not that.
You know?
Hello? No.
Yeah, Dr. Ahmed is here.
Thank you. Yeah, hello. Hello, Prof. Ahmed. Hello, Prof.
We'd like to welcome you to this workshop. We believe that your talk will be valuable to the researchers in quantum computing.
Thank you, Prof. Ahmed, for your inviting me as a speaker in this distinguished research, this distinguished event, and I hope this talk will be valuable and add value for some beginner researchers, inshallah. Are you hearing me, please?
Yeah.
Okay. Today we will
maximize the PowerPoint to be visible.
It is ready now.
The PowerPoint, just slideshow. Make it visible.
Okay now.
Okay, very good. You can go on. Okay.
The main objective of this talk is that by proposing a simple modification on Deutsch's problem, we prove that quantum computers solve some problems that are impossible to be solved by classical computers, even if these problems are quite simple. Deep Deutsch, who is the father of quantum algorithm. We know that for n boolean variables, there are 2^2 n boolean functions. If n equal 1, then we have only a single boolean variable x, which may take 0 or 1. For this single boolean variable, we can generate 2^2 boolean functions. So the first function is f0, which is 0 for x equals 0 and 0 for f for x equal 1 and 1 for x equals 0 and 1 for x equal 1. The third function is 0 for x equals 0 and 1 for x equal 1. The last function is 1 for x equals 0 and 0 for x equal 1. Deutsch called these two functions constant function because these two functions are constant. However, he called these two functions are balanced function because the number of zeros equals the number of one. We know that Deutsch's problems is proved that quantum computers are faster than classical computers. Given a black box UF for computing an unknown function. These functions may be one of these four functions. The goal of Deutsch's problem is that he needs to classify the black box UF as a constant function or balanced function. So he generated constant function by f of 0 equal f of 1. And generated f of 0 not equal f of 1 of 1 if these functions are balanced functions. What is Deutsch algorithm? Deutsch algorithm is done by four steps. In the first step, he initializes the quantum system by two qubits. In the first qubit, the first qubit is initialized by state 0, and the second qubit is initialized by state 1. Then, by applying Hadamard gate on each qubit, so by applying H in the first qubit, it will evaluate to k0 plus k1 over root 2. And when applying Hadamard gate on the second qubit, it evolved it to k0 minus k1 over root 2. So by tensor product, we have this state. The third step, the oracle is applied on the two qubit according to this rule. The oracle keeps the first qubit unchanged and XORing the second qubit by Y XOR function f of x. So by applying this rule, here is the first qubit, which is x, and here is the second qubit, which is y. So by applying uf, the first qubit is unchanged. So here x, so 0 will be it is, 0 will be it is, 1 will be it is, and 1 will be it is. Now, we will apply the oracle according to this rule. It XORing the second qubit with the function of the first qubit. So, here 0, XOR f of 0. Here 1, XORing f of 0. And here 1, it is, and 0, it's only f of 1. Here 1, it is, and here 1, it's only f of 1. Then we apply Hadamard gate in the first qubit. After applying the Hadamard gate in the first qubit, the state of the first qubit will be 0 with a global phase plus or minus if the applied oracle is a constant function. And the state of the first qubit will be k1 if the applied oracle is balanced function. So when we measure the first qubit, we will get output 0 if the applied oracle is a constant function. And we get 1 if the applied oracle is a balanced function. Now let us show the complexity of Deutsch's algorithm. Classically, we call the oracle twice in order to show the value of f, the applied function for x equals 0, and once again to show the value of the function for x equals 1. So we need to call the oracle twice in order to decide whether the applied oracle is a constant or balanced. On the other hand, According to Deutsch's algorithm, we need to recall the black box or the oracle only one time. So the complexity of this problem is of order one. So the classical computer is slower to solve this problem than quantum computer. Here in this talk, we need to make a simple modification on Deutsch's problem. First, given an unknown qubit, alpha k0 plus beta k1 in a pure state, such that absolute value of alpha must be greater than 0, and the modulus beta must be greater than 0, and the modulus alpha not equal to modulus beta. Second, an oracle represents an unknown Boolean function is applied in T. And we have two goals. In the first goal, we need to classify the oracle into one of two classes, constant function or balanced function. Second, we need to estimate the value of modulus alpha and the value of modulus beta with some relative error. Remark, if modulus alpha equals 0 or modulus beta equals 0, then the proposed problem is converted to the standard Deutsch problem. Here, this problem cannot be solved using classical computers because the unknown qubit cannot be implemented on classical computers. So this problem cannot be solved absolutely on classical computers. Now, before we show the proposed algorithm that solves this problem, we need to speak about a new computing model based on entanglement degree. This diagram shows the main operation of the proposed quantum computing model. Here we have a system of qubit, epsilon of t. This system may be initialized by Hadamard gates or initialized by any quantum source. And we attach two qubit, G and H, which are initialized in the vacuum state zero. Then we apply some unitary operations between the first n qubit and get G. Therefore, we apply MZ operator. MZ operator has two main operations. In the first operation, we create entanglement between the qubit G and the qubit H. Then we measure the degree of entanglement between G and H. Then the solution of the problem at hand can be obtained by one of two techniques. In the first technique, the solution may be obtained by check the presence or absence the entanglement between these two qubits. In the second technique, we solve the problem at hand by quantifying the degree of entanglement between these two qubits. This paper shows how this model works and how can be implemented to circuit model, and it has two theorems that show the main operation of this model. This model was used to solve some quantum computing algorithms, such as such as non-classical computing problems, which was published in Results in Physics, and we proposed a quantum algorithm to classify Boolean multivariable function into novel hidden classes, which is the generalization of Deutsch-Jozsa problem. In quantum machine learning, we proposed two new algorithms based in this model. The first modules proposed in 2019, and the second module was proposed in 2020. What is entanglement measure? We know that for an arbitrary composite system of two qubit described by the state xi, is called two qubit entangled system if and only if it cannot always be written mathematically in the product form xi not equal xi1 tensor product xi2. Although this mathematical definition is simple, but it cannot be quantified, the degree of entanglement in a two qubit system. So we need a measure to quantify the degree of entanglement between a two qubit system. In 1989, authors proposed a concurrence as a measure for the degree of entanglement between two qubit systems. His measure was published in this paper. Now let us show what is concurrence measure. Consider an arbitrary two qubit system in a pure state described as xi equal d node 00 plus d 101 plus d 210 plus d 311. Now concurrence can be calculated according to authors as follows. Concurrence is bra xi sigma y tensor product sigma y xi dagger. Where sigma y is the Pauli sigma. So by applying this rule, we show that the concurrence is quantified according to this rule. Concurrence equal to modulus d1 times d2 minus d node times d3. Such that concurrence is bounded in the interval 0 and 1. If the concurrence value is 0, this means that these two qubits are separable or disentangled. If the concurrence equal 1, this means these two qubits are maximally entangled. And if it between 0 and 1, this means there is a degree of entanglement between them. Now we know that if we have a two qubit system in this form, we can quantify the concurrence according to this rule. But there is a challenge. This form cannot be calculated in quantum computers because we know that in order to make some calculation in quantum computers, we need to follow the four postulates of quantum computing. In 2007, Romerio and others proposed a circuit. This circuit can be used to quantify the degree of entanglement for a system in this form. So by applying this circuit, we have this state before measurement process. So if we have a two qubit T and D, and we have another copy of these two qubits, we can apply sigma y on the third qubit and fourth qubit, and then apply C node gate on the second qubit and fourth qubit. Then we apply x and h in the second qubit. Here, before measurement, we have this state. So this is the state after applying the mentioned gates. Now let us compare the Waters formula and compare this formula. We show that this term d1 times d2 minus d0 times d3 is obtained in the probability amplitude of state 0, 0, 0, 0 and the probability amplitude of state 1, 0, 1, 0. Here this term and this term is this term. So it's easy to check that the concurrence can be quantified quantum mechanically on any quantum computers by this form, by estimation the probability of state 0000 or 1010. The complete explanation of this form can be shown in this paper. Now, let us remember our proposed problem. Now, we have an unknown qubit in this form, such that modulus alpha not equal zero and modulus beta not equal zero. And we have an oracle applied on this qubit. And we have two goals. The first goal, we need to classify the given oracle into one of two classes, constant function or balanced function. Then we estimate the absolute value of alpha and the absolute value of beta with some relative error. Now we will proceed to the proposed algorithm. In the first step, we initialize the quantum system by attach the given unknown qubit with a single ancilla qubit D, which is initialized in the vacuum state zero. So by attaching, we make a tensor product. So alpha get zero, tensor product zero. So alpha zero zero plus beta one get zero is plus beta one get one zero. Now we apply the oracle according to the mentioned rule in the Deutsch algorithm. So we leave the first qubit unchanged. L0 is it is, and 1 is it is. Now we apply the XOR operation between the second qubit and the function of the first qubit. So 0 XOR f of 0. And here 0 XOR f of 1. Now we repeat the steps 1 and 2 to obtain another copy of the state psi 1. Here there is some confusion. Someone may ask, we cannot make a clone or copy of the state in quantum system. Yeah, it is right. But here we don't violate non-cloning theorem, because when we repeat step 1, we initialize a new different quantum system. And when we apply the second step, we get the same state. So we don't violate the non-cloning theorem. Now we estimate the concurrence value by applying the Lemieux circuit on the two qubits. And the concurrence here can be quantified by this form, C equal radical 2 times BS, where BS is the probability of state 0, 0, 0, 0, plus probability of state 0, 1, 0, 0, plus probability of state 1, 0, 1, 0, plus probability 1, 1, 0. Someone asked me, in the previous slides, we mentioned just B 0, 0, 0, 0, and 1010. Why this probability and this probability? This will be explained in the analysis of the proposed algorithm. Now, after estimating the concurrence value, if we get C equal 0, then the applied oracle represents a constant function f of 0 equal f of 1. And if the concurrence is greater than 0, this means that there is entanglement between the qubit D and D, and hence we can prove that the applied oracle is a balanced function. Then we estimate the absolute value of alpha according to this equation. Absolute value equal the fourth root of 2 times B0011, or our fourth root of 2B011, or a mix of them. And the beta, it's easy. If we have modulus alpha, we can find modulus beta. Now let us analyze the performance of the proposed algorithm. We know that in step 1, we just make a tensor product between the unknown qubit, which we may obtain from a teleportation process or any other quantum source, with the qubit D, which is initialized in state 0. Then we apply the oracle according to this rule. Now, let us investigate the algorithm in the four possibilities. Now, if the applied oracle is a constant function, if the applied oracle is a constant function, then we have two cases. In the first case, the applied function is f of 0 according to the table 1. So f of 0 equals 0 and f of 1 equals 0. So when we apply this rule, as we mentioned before, the first qubit is it is, and we apply the XORing operation between the second qubit and the function of the first qubit. So 0 is it is, here 1 is it is, and for the second qubit is 0 XOR f of 0, and here 0 XOR f of 1. So in case the applied oracle is the represents the Boolean function f 0, then here f of 0 is 0 and here f of 1 is 0. So 0 XOR 0 is 0 and 0 XOR 0 is 0, so we can take kit 0 as a common factor in the second qubit. Then we apply the third step to make another copy. We repeat step 1 and step 2 to make another copy, and we apply the Remeriu circuit. After we apply the Remeriu circuit, we have this state before measurement process. We estimate, according to step 4, we estimate the concurrence value using this form, C equal to time BS under the radical. Here, BS is the probability of state 0, 0, 0, 0. In this case, if the oracle is represents F0, then we show that the probability of 0, 0, 0 is 0. And the probability of 0, 1, 0, 0 is 0. And the probability of 1, 0, 1, 0 is, it is clear it is 0. And the probability of state 1, 1, 1, it is clear that it is 0. So the concurrence here is 0, and the entanglement between the qubit D, T and D is vanished. Now, let's show the second case. Also, we can quantify the absolute value of alpha using this form, as we explained in the proposed algorithm. Now, let us show the second case. If the applied oracle represents the Boolean function f1, we know that f1, f of 0 equal 1, and f1, f of 1 equal 1. So, by applying this rule, we show that 0 is it is, and here 1 is it is, according to this rule. And here we make XORing between the second qubit and the function of the first qubit. So 0 XOR f of 0, here f of 0 is 1. So 0 XOR 1 is 1. And here 0 XOR f of 1, so 0 XOR f of 1 is 1. So 0 XOR 1 is 1. So we can take kit 1 as a common factor in the second qubit. After we repeat step 1 and 2 to get another copy, and we apply the Remeriu circuit, we have this state before measurement process. Now we estimate the concurrence. It is clear that the probability of state 0, 0, 0, 0 is 0, and 0, 1, 0, 0 is 0, and the probability of state 1, 0, 1, 0 is 0, and the probability of state 1, 1, 1, 0 is 0. So the concurrence between these two qubits is vanished. Also, it is clear that from this state, the absolute value of alpha is estimated according to this rule. So we show that the probability of the value of alpha obtained by the probability of state 0011 and the probability of state 011. And it's easy to compute the absolute value of beta according to this rule. Now, what about if the applied oracle is balanced function? So in balanced function, f of 0 not equal f of 1. So let us take f2. In f2, f of 0 equals 0 and f of 1 equal 1. So when we apply the second step according to this rule, so 0 is it is, here 1 is it is, and here 0 xoring f of 0, and here f of 0 is 0, so 0 xoring 0 is 0. So the first ticket is 0 and 0, plus beta, 1 it is, and 0 xor f of 1, f of 1 equals 1, so 0 xor 1 is 1. So it is clear that this state is entangled state, and the concurrence value can be calculated according to Wolters' law, Wolters' formula from this for c equal 2 times modulus alpha times beta. But we know that this formula cannot be calculated according to the solution of quantum computing, so we make another copy and apply the Romero-Eitel operation, Romero-Eitel circuit. Now, let us estimate the concurrence. Here, the concurrence is the probability of state 000. Here, the probability of state 0000 not equal 0. And the probability of state 0100 not equal 0. And the probability of state 1010 not equal 0. And the probability of state 1110 not equal 0. So the concurrence is greater than 0. So there is entanglement between the first qubit and the second qubit. Also, we can quantify the absolute value of alpha by this form, because the probability of state 0011 is 4 alpha power 4 over 2, and the probability of state 0111 is alpha power 4 over root 2. And it's easy, if we have alpha, it's easy to calculate the absolute value of beta. In the last case, the oracle can take this function, fc. And fc, f of 0 equal 1 and f of 1 equal 0. So by applying the rule, we have this state, alpha get 0, 1 plus beta get 1, 0. And it is clear that this state is entangled state. So the concurrence is 2 modulus alpha beta. This is theoretically, but in order to quantify it quantum mechanically, we need to make another copy and apply the Romero-Eitel circuit and quantify the concurrence according to this rule. It is clear, once again, it is clear that the probability of state 0000 not equal 0, and the probability of state 0100 not equal 0, and the probability of state 1010 not equal 0, and the probability of state 1110 not equal 0. So the concurrence is greater than 0. This means that the applied oracle is a balanced Boolean function. Once again, we can quantify the absolute value of alpha by this form. So it is clear that if the applied oracle represents a constant function, then there is no entanglement between the given qubit and the target qubit. And if the applied oracle is a balanced function, we will found that there is entanglement between the first qubit and the second qubit. So we can solve the proposed problem to prove that quantum computer can solve some problems which are cannot be applicable in classical computers. Now, what about the error estimation of the concurrence value? We showed that C equal root 2 BS, and here BS is defined by the probability of these four states. It's easy to squaring the two sides, and using Gödel's formula, we prove that BS equals C power 2 over 2, or 2 modulus alpha beta squared. So, the standard error of measuring BS is root k times BS times 1 minus BS over k. Here k is the number of shots that apply on the whole system. So the standard error of estimation, the concurrence value, is defined by this form. Now, what about the error of estimating modulus alpha? Here we know that B alpha equal B0011 plus B, probability of state 0111, which is modulus alpha power 4. So the standard error of B alpha is defined by this formula, such that K is the number of shots, and the standard error can be quantified by this formula. Now we are going to realize the proposed algorithm using real IBM quantum computer. First, the experimental setup. We made 4 experiments. Each experiment represents one function. And we assume that the unknown qubit are given by t equals this form, and t equals this form, and t equals this form. And this is the circuit model of the proposed algorithm. We t is the which assumed to be unknown for everyone, but it is known only for us. And here t is unknown for everyone and known only for the experiment designers. So we apply the proposed algorithm using this quantum circuit. And this is the results which we obtained from the IBM quantum computer and IBM quantum simulator. The blue bars represent the real values of a real quantum computer, and the red bars represent the theoretical values, and the green bars represent the simulation results. It is clear that the experiments match with the theoretical and simulator with high fidelity. And this is for F1, when we apply F1, and here when we apply F2, it is clear that when there is entanglement, the results are typically matched between theoretical and real values of quantum computers. Here is some difference, slight difference compared with a disentangled state. And here is the values which we obtained by real quantum computer and simulator compared with theoretical. So these values of modulus alpha for kt equal root 1 over 4 0 and root 3 over 4, and here for root 1 over 3, and here for uniform superposition. And the statistical fidelities of the implemented circuits using IBM quantum computer. It is clear that the statistical validity is the proposed algorithm is realized by higher statistical fidelity. Also, we proved our analysis by making quantum state tomography for the four cases, and this is the quantum state tomography for F0, and this is the quantum state tomography for F1, and this is quantum state tomography for F2, and this is the quantum state tomography for F3, and it is clear that the quantum state tomography is provide the theoretical results with high fidelity. Quantum state tomography, I made a long lecture in summer school of Alexandria since 2 years ago. The main results of this talk were published in Results in Physics journal with Prof. Hisham Lesh and Prof. Mahmoud Abdulati. In a summary, in 1985, the fathers of quantum algorithm, David Deutsch, proposed the first algorithm that shows that quantum computers are faster than classical computers. In this session, by proposing a simple modification on Deutsch's problem, we prove that quantum computers solve some problems that are impossible to be solved by classical computers, even if the problems are quite simple. So now we draw the attention of the researchers to new type of quantum computing problems that cannot be solved absolutely on classical computers. This will be made a significant progress in drug discovery. For any more explanation, this is my mail. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Zidane, for this interesting talk. Karim, is there any questions you have from the attendees?
For now, I know no one asked anything up until now, but thanks a lot, Dr. Mohamed Zidane, for your talk and your time and your efforts. Great results and congratulations on the publication. Great effort.
Actually, I have one question for Dr. Mohamed. Actually, I'm quite confused. So you are trying to test if the function is balanced or constant, or you are trying to find the value of alpha and beta, the unknown alpha and beta, or you are trying to calculate the concurrence, because these are three challenges in the same paper. So which one you are trying to solve?
Okay, thank you for this good question. I just need to return back to the proposed problem.
Because you have many unknowns in the paper, so I get confused. You have to have something given.
Yeah, thank you for your question. The internet is quite slow. Okay. Well, this is the proposed problem. Here we are given an unknown qubit under conditions that modulus alpha not equal zero, modulus beta not equal zero, and modulus alpha not equal modulus beta. This is the first condition on the given unknown qubit, which we can provide it by a teleportation apparatus or a quantum source in the lab. The second given is an oracle. This oracle represents a single Boolean function. We have two goals. The first goal is to classify the oracle into one of two classes, quiescent function or balanced function. This is our first goal. The second goal, we need to quantify or estimate the value of modulus alpha and modulus beta with some relative error. This is our problem. Concurrence is used to solve this problem and to achieve the first goal.
Okay, thank you, Dr. Muhammad. I got
it. It is clear.
To solve two goals, okay.
Two goals. And the concurrence is computed according to Remulio circuit. This is the unknown qubit, T, and this is the oracles, and this part compute the concurrence. Now?
Okay, yeah.
Okay, can I ask a question here?
Okay.
Okay, what was the quantum circuit depth?
I'm so sorry?
The circuit depth, the depth of the circuit, or how many consecutive operations did you have?
I got it. In quantum algorithm, we don't care about how many operations we made. In quantum algorithm, we only focus how many you call the oracle. And this is the objective of this seminar. Here, we focus on a new type of problems that can solve it only in quantum computer and cannot be applicable absolutely in classical computers. So the depths, I didn't care about the depths, I didn't care about anything. I only care about the solution of the problem, because this problem cannot be solved on classical computers. So I don't care about how many I applied the oracle and how many I applied the operations.
Okay, so which quantum system have you used on the IPMQ experience?
I think I mentioned it, IQ, IBM, let's check this. Because the results of this paper consumed 2 years.
Wow.
Okay. IBM QX4.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
Is there any question from the audience about this?
I need to listen to the audience, please.
You need what? I'm sorry?
The question is very important for me.
Which one?
For anyone have a question?
So I'm asking again, does anyone here have any question for Dr. Muhammad Zidane? Okay, it seems not. So thank you so much for your presentation.
Thank you for Prof. Ahmed, thank you for Dr. Basha, thank you for NG Karim, and it's my pleasure to be with you today. Thank you very much. Thank you.
It is our pleasure. Okay, I will stop recording right now.